In terms of successes, I would have to say, I guess I'm particularly fond of one which I wouldn't have pulled up as an idea in years, but we received a proposal from one of the membrane manufacturers to put together a consortium of membrane manufacturers. And the objective of this was, strangely enough, large elements. The industry has pretty much standardized on an 8-inch diameter reverse osmosis element, and that's what most plants were being built to. The idea was to come up with a new standard size for reverse osmosis elements. Now, when one then says, well, suppose we have a 16-inch element, that means the vessels that used to hold XYZ's elements can hold ABC's elements. It further means when we go to buy some new elements, we can have competition. Always a good thing price-wise for the buyer. So anyhow, they proposed to set up a consortium, and they spent approximately a year's time discussing this issue. And the only issue at hand was this diameter. And each meeting was preceded by a legal discussion of what they would not discuss. Now, what this means was that the U.S. government paid $100,000, which was our contribution, for one number. And it's not a secret because it's in the report, but that number happens to be 15.9 plus or minus 0.01 inch. Now, it turns out that I was in Israel last year, and they are building the first big desalination plant to use this size element. And unfortunately, I couldn't tour the plant, but I did have the opportunity of going up and visiting the technical vice president of the company who's building the plant, Boris Lieberman. And I asked Boris, how much did you save by using the 16-inch elements? And he said, we're guessing that it's about 25% of the capital cost of the plant. And my guess is that if that's correct, somebody has saved somewhere between $25 and $50 million. And personally, I regard that as a very good expenditure of $100,000.